Hello students, in this lecture also we are going to see pest of four small crops, fruits crops, that is bear, papaya, jamun and apple, right? Like a previous lecture, let's start from bear fruit. This fruit helps you sleep better and chronic constipation relief and solve the anxiety, and it is rich in vitamin C and regulates blood pressure and regulates blood circulation well and also improves bone strength. These are just some points regards bear, right? Let's see the pest cause damage on fruit crops, bear fruit crops. First one is fruit fly. It's a common fruit fly. It is special genus, that is Carpomia vesuviana tepritidae order diptera. So making puncture on fruits and it will shows the gummy exudation on attacked fruits. And coming to biology, egg period is 2 to 3 days. Their eggs laid in cavities made on fruits by the oviposition and 22 eggs laid by a single female. Maggot periods about 7 to 10 days and pupal periods about 15 to 30 days. Their pupation takes place in soil and adult is small black spotted fly with banded wings. For the management, we can go for resistant variety like Safidae, Ilachi and Chinese Senar 1 and Marchia and Ticadi and Amran. These are the resistant variety we can use against this fruit fly. And collect and destroy the affected plant pots and plowing for remove the pupae, kill the pupation and trap. Use methane eugenol lure trap 25 per hectare to monitor and kill the adults of fruit flies, and prepare methyl eugenol and malathion 50 is mixture as 1:1 ratio and take 10 ml of mixture per trap. Also use bait like molasses or jaggery 10 gram per liter and malathion 50 EC 2 ml or carbaryl 50 WP 4 gram per liter for 2 rounds at fortnight interval before ripening of fruits, that is 2 weeks. And insecticides, malathion 50 EC and dimethyl 30 EC can be used against the fruit fly. Next insect is bear fruit borers, Meridarchus cyrodus, Carpocinidae, Lepidoptera. Here larvae, it is a reddish in color and adult is small dark brown moth. Fecundity of adult female is 14 eggs. Here egg period is 5 days and larval period is 18 days and pupal period is 9 days. Adult longevity is 3 to 5 days. For the management, you can go for collection and destruction of damaged fruits and rack the soil for kill the pupae and apply chloroperipos at 1.5 D at 40 kg per hectare around the tree before the fruits attain to marble stage and spray malathion or dimethyl at the time of fruit set. Next one is leaf butterfly Taricus indicus, Lycanidae, Lepidoptera. Here it is a small fleshy green caterpillars feed on leaves. Their egg period is about 5 days, larval period about 15 days and pupal period about 1 week. Here it is white transparent patches are seen on leaves and adults have white wings with pale brown bands on the ventral side. And next one is hairy caterpillar Euproctix fraternae, Limantidae, Lepidoptera. Their site of egg laying, you all know about this, and lower surface of leaves. For the biology, so egg period is about 10 days, female lays eggs in groups, their larvae about 1 month period, full grown larvae as a red head and a dark reddish brown body completely covered with white hairs and a single tuft of hairs in head and pre-anal segment. Pupation about 25 days, pupates in a silken cocoon. Here adults, a medium sized yellowish color with pale transverse lines and 3 black spots on border of the forewing. And next hairy caterpillar species are Volanae mentosa. It's a larvae, the grayish with the yellowish tuft, T-U-F-T-S, tuft and longitudinal reddish stripes on dorsal side, feed on leaves irregularly and voraciously. And Orgia postica, it's a brown larvae with yellowish and white tuft of hairs feed on leaves irregularly. Here female winglers and usually cling to pupal cases and lay white eggs in groups in and around. The nest is so many scintillants. Cervopolypagus pest causing heavy defoliation. Here common symptoms for hairy caterpillar is scrabbing and heavy defoliation and irregular feeding. Scrabbing is a main symptom of hairy caterpillar. And next one is the lac insect, the Lacifera laca, Pteridae hemiptera. So lac insect attack the fruit crop in the course, that is bur. Host range is bur, kusum, palas and car, pomegranate, amla, litchi and tamarind. Symptom of lac insect on bur crop, that is desapping by adult, reduce the vitality and vigor of trees and cottony appearance due to long wax filament and sooty mold appearance on the leaves. Here adults lays 200 to 500 eggs and hatch within the few hours. Here emerging nymphs crawl on branches, settle down gregariously and start sucking the sap. Once settled, the nymphs do not move and start segregating resins from glands. They lack secretion from adjacent cells to form a continuous encrustation. For the management, prune all the severely attacked branches or twigs and burn without delay. And avoid overcrowding and growing other lac insect host plant like white bear in the vicinity of fruit trees area. And spray dimethyl for the effective control in the period of April and again in September. Next one is common gastric semilooper, Achaea janata, not today, Hebdoptera. Or Acantho delta janata. So major pest of castor. Symptom is heavy defoliation. Next one is Tussock caterpillar, Artaxa guttata, Limantidae, Lepidoptera, defoliation and scrapping of leaves. And Indian wax scale, Ceroplastus seriferus, Coccidae hemiptera. And Cryptocephalus sexinatus, Rhizomelidae, Coleoptera. And Drapanococcus kajani, Coccidae hemiptera. And Hemospidoproctus cinereus, Coccidae hemiptera. These are the scale insect attack the bare fruit, which cause the yellowing of leaves. In severe cases, it will cause a wilting symptom. And next crop, that is papaya. The papaya, it protect against heart disease and improves digestion and protect eyesight and prevent cancer. And finally, it will boost immune system. These are the some health benefits of papaya. We enter the pest topic. First one is major one, Papaya mealybug, Paracoccus marginatus, Pseudococcidae hemiptera. Invasive pest. India is a leader in papaya production. It contributing to approximately 50% of world production, that is 6 million tons of fruits. It is cultivated in the states of Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Orissa, West Bengal, Assam, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Madhya Pradesh in about 8,000 hectares. It is the papaya mealybug, Paracoccus marginatus, invaded in India, first recorded being on papaya plants from Coimbatore in July 2008. It has now spread to Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Tripura due to the movement of infested fruits and plant pots. Here mealybug infestation appears on above ground pots on leaves, stems and fruits as a cluster of cotton like mosses. The insect suck the sap by inserting its stylets into the epidermis on the leaf, fruits and stems. While feeding, it injects the toxic substance into the leaves, resulting in chlorosis. Here, and also cause the plant stunting, leaf deformation and crinkling. Finally, the fruit drops and leads to death of plants. The honeydew secretion by the bug results in the formation of sooty mold, which interferes in photosynthesis or affect the photosynthesis and cause further damages to crops. Here heavy infestation are capable of rendering fruits inedible due to the buildup of thick waxy coating or thick white waxy coating. Is that correct? Right, okay. Next, when live specimen collected from papaya or crushed on paper, the body color would be yellow. but when killed and preserved in 80% of alcohol at room temperature, the body content would turn completely black within 48 hours. And here, female has no wings and move by crawling a short distance or by being blown in air current or air flow. Here, host range of mealybugs, Podopagus pest, attacking several agriculture and horticulture crops like tapioca, coffee, jimpy, cotton, okra, tomato, brinjal, teak, silk cotton, cetropa, mulberry, plumeria, and numerous weed-like plants like parthenium, mistroporus, sida, acuta, acalypa, indica, and cassia, serica. Female, so coming to biology, here females usually lays 100 to 600 eggs. Okay, eggs are greenish yellow and are laid in the RVSAC, that is a sac that is 3 to 4 times body length and entirely covered with wax, white wax. This RVSAC is developed ventrally on the adult female. And egg laying usually continues over a period of 1 to 2 weeks. Her egg hatches in about 10 days. And nymphs or crawlers begin to actively search for feeding sites. And adult males may be extinguished from the other related species by the presence of stout, fleshy setae that is actually present on antenna, and absence of fleshy setae that is actually present on legs. Female have 3 instar and males have 4 instar. Here male have longer development time, that is 1 month, and female having 26 days developing time. It needs 25 plus or minus 1 degree Celsius and 65 plus or minus 2% RH for the effective development, growth and development. Here adult females attract the males with the sex pheromones. Here under greenhouse condition, reproduction occurs throughout the year. You can see the picture. Here is association of ant, that is Oikophila sparaconitina, with papaya mealybug on Jetropa, that is left side, and custard IFP, that is right side. Before the management, we have to monitor and detect the early presence of mealybug and pruning and removal of affected plant pots and burn it. And removal of weeds or alternate hosts like hibiscus, parthenium, etc. And avoid the movement of affected plant material from one side to another area. And avoiding flood irrigation. And prevention of the movement the ant and destruction of already existing ant colonies and sanitization of farm equipments before moving it to the uninfested crops and application of sticky bands or alkathene sheets or a band of insecticide on arms or main stem to prevent the movement of crawler, that is banding. And you can see the natural enemies, the effective natural enemies like Spalgius and Cryptolemus and Cymnus. A and B are Spalgius APS, A is a larvae, B is adult. And C is Cymnus craxi or adult, and D is Cryptolemus montrosauri grub. These are the effective predators can be used against our Paracarpus marginatus. Here, chemical control is only partially effective and requires multiple application. And apply recommended chemical insecticide as a last report, such as the propanophos and chloripyrifos, bupropion, thimethiot, thimethoxam, and imidacloprid at a recommended rate. Next pest is whitefly, Bemisia tapacin, Aleurodidae hemiptera. Here, nymphs and adults suck the sap from underside of leaves and it transmit papaya leaf curl virus, the vector of papaya leaf curl virus. The infested plant shows leaf curling, crinkling, distortion of leaves, reduction of leaf lamella, rolling of leaf margin, and the rolling of leaf margin inward and downward, both are causing by our Bemisia tapacin, and thickening of veins and leathery, brittle and distorted. A plant stunted and does not produce a flower and fruits. And next second pest or F is gossipy and Mysus persicae, FEDD hemiptera. Here it transmit papaya ring spot virus, salsa vector, and the affected leaves shows vein clearing and puckering and chlorophyll leaf tissue lobing in margin and distal parts of leaf, and this leaf rolls downward and inward. Both are causing by aphids. And mosaic mottling, dark green blisters, leaf distortion, which result in shoestring symptom and stunting of plants. On fruits, circular concentric rings are produced, and fruit fly Dactrosira dorsalis or Dorcas dorsalis. Here maggots puncture into the semi-ripe fruits with decayed spots, resulting in oozing of fluid and brownish rotten patches on fruits and dropping of fruits. Here maggots is yellowish, adult fly is light brown with the transparent wing. Next one is ash weevil, Millocera species, Carculionidae coleoptera. Here grub feed on the roots while adult cause notching of leaf margin. And coming to scale insect complex, that is first one is Aspidiota destructors, this hard scale category. Next scale insect species are Onidiella orientalis or oriental red scale, Hemibursillaria latanae, so latania scale, and quince scale, Eucalymnatus tessellatus, that is a palm scale or tessellated scale, and Trepanococcus chiton, that is pigeon pea or papaya or brinjal scale insect, Pseudonidia trilobitiformis, that is cashew scale or trilobit scale. Next one is Nipecoccus viridis, that is a spherical mealybug, and Alaerodicus dispersus, that is spiraling whitefly. Here Ailey polypagus pest, so the introduced pest which over 160 host plant including agriculture and horticulture crops and ornamental crop. Next one is Fericia virgata, say two-tailed striped mealybug or Goa mealybug or grey mealybug. The symptom of damages are yellowing of leaves and terminal shoots. Presence of large number of mealybug having a pair of long wax threads at caudal end on undersurface of leaves and stems which are coated with sooty mold and wilted of plants in patches. Next one is Pseudococcus Jack Beardsley, that is Jack Beardsley mealybug. The mealybug known to occur in many other Asian countries including Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, Cambodia or Vietnam, Thailand and Maldives. It is neotropic origin like the other recent invasive mealybugs in India. Next crop is Jamun. Eating of jamuns treats diabetes and cure liver disorders and improves cardiovascular health and treats anemia and increase appetite and treats constipation and stimulate melanin making cells and thus treat leukoderma and treats bladder issues and cures renal stone condition and helps to maintain the healthy voice and stimulates nervous system and increase memory and treat acidity and nausea. I think I need this Jamun to improve my voice. Okay, next fruit fly Dorcas coryctex, Tepridae diptera, and yellow colored maggot is responsible for premature dropping and rotting of fruits. The adult is white brown fly with the transparent wing. Next one is leaf caterpillar Caria angulata, not today Lepidoptera, a greenish brown color larvae with the swollen anterior part of body feed on leaves. Purple winged moth, Bombatelia dilatrix, not today Lepidoptera, here green colored larvae feed on leaves. Adult is brownish black moth. Next one is Thrips, Luvenia Ramakrishni, Thripidae Thysanoptera. Symptom is yellowing with silvery patches. Next one is Psyllid, Triopsa Jambulanae, Psyllidae Hemiptera. Symptom is yellowing and malformation of leaves. And white fly, Dialaerodus Eugenie, Alaerodidae Hemiptera. Symptom is yellowing and malformation of leaves. And Hairy Caterpillar, Trabala Vishnu, Lassia Combidae, Heblaptera. Here widely distributed in oriental region including India, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Malaysia and Indonesia. Here adults are sexually dimorphic in overall coloration with males pale green and females bright yellow. And the larvae feed on wide range of host plants including castor, jamun, pomegranate, rose, sandalwood, etc. Last crop is apple. This apple stimulates weight loss, balance blood sugar level and strengthen immunity, and improve your eyesight and great for your teeth and gum and build stronger bones, give your energy and relieve muscular tension and etc. Regards to pest, the major one is woolly aphids, it is omalanigerum, pembicidae, hemipterum. Here, reproduction mostly occur by the parthenogenesis type of reproduction and nymphal period is about 35 to 42 days and nymphs having 5 instar and wingless form present throughout the year and winged form from occur only July to October. Here adults is purplish aphid covered with white cottony mats and we can use the resistant variety to minimize this problem. It is M series of apple, that is M778, M779 and MM14 and MM110. We can also release the parasitoid like Abelinis molly and predators like Chylomenes bijugus and Coccinella septum punctatum. Here insecticide can be used like dimethyote or methyl dimetone in the time of March to April and June. Next one is Sanjo's kale, Cotraspidiotus perniciosus diaspidida hemiptera. It's having nymphal hibernation, here female, so ovoviviparous and produce 200 to 400 nymphs. And crawlers secretes waxy covering in about 4 days. A nymphal period is about 20 days. A female is yellowish orange round slightly convex with a black pustule and male is small and linear in shape. Total life cycle is about 40 days. Sanus scale cause injury by feeding on twigs, branches and fruits. They may also inject the saliva, that is a toxic saliva while feeding. That is heavy preparation on bark can cause gumming and kill the twigs, branches and the entire tree if left uncontrolled. A red halo like discoloration often form around the insect on small twigs or infested fruits. It's a peculiar symptom, red halo like discoloration. For the management, we have to select the stock free scale infestation and also encourage the activities of parasitoids, coccinellates like Chylochorus circumtatus. It's a predator and fumigate nursery stock with oxygen gas or methyl bromide. Here summer spray with phasoline or phenytoin and methyl dimetone and winter spray with diesel oil emulsion at 8 to 12 liter per tree. That should be diesel oil, that is 4.5 liter, soap about 1 kg, water should be 52 to 72 liters. Next one is cottony cushion scale, Isaria purchasi, Margaroridae hemipterum. Here nymphs and adults cause yellowing of leaves. Female is white cottony RVSAC. Here nymphs is pinkish crawlers with the long antennae group of hairs. For the management, select healthy and pest free root stock and collect and destroy the infected plant pots. Also spray the application of neem oil and MSKE. The chemicals may be chloripyrifos and field release of some coccinellate predators, Chylochorus nigrita and stem borer, Apriana cinereae, Lamidae family, Coleoptera. Here grub feeding result in branches having small circular hole with mass of excreta. Here chewed up wood particle protrude out and bark gnawed and leaves defoliated. Here trunk hollowed out and the infested trees remain stunted. Here adult beetles feed on barks and have an unusual habit of cutting more than they actually consume. Here vitality and productivity is greatly impaired. Grub is creamy yellow with dark brown flat head and adult is ashy grey bleed beetle with numerous black tubercles at a base of elytra. For the management, we have to prune the branches and containing grubs before they enter the tree trunk. Also injection of 10 ml of monocrotophos and plug with wet clay to kill the grub. Next one is tent caterpillar, Malacosoma indica. Lasiocombidae lepidopteron. It causes heavy defoliation and egg period about 5 days. It lays on mosses about 300 to 400 on branches, and larval period about 40 to 70 days. Larvae with black head and abdomen, also black. And pupal is about 7 to 21 days. Pupation occurs in stem as cocoon. Adult is light brown moth. For the management, you have to destroy the all egg batches on the branches during pruning the insecticide. And the carbaryl 50 WP, carbaryl 50 W is commonly used to for controlling various type of hairy caterpillar species. And codling moth, Cydia pomonella tortricidae lepidopteron. Here larvae burrow into the fruit and feed on the pulp. The fruits cause distorted and fruit rot, and fruits can't be marketed. Here larvae enter through calyx and feed up to the central core. Here larvae is pinkish white caterpillar with brown head. Larval period is around 1 month. Then it comes out and fall on the ground. It shelter in cracks, cervix of the box. Then it spin cocoon, silken cocoon, and pupae is yellowish brown. Moth is brown, four wings are dark greenish, marked with wavy lines, blends with the bark by making in conspicuous. For the management, you have to go for field sanitation and collect and destruction of affected plant pots, fruits and cocoons, and banding. The corrugated cardboard bands should be applied to tree trunk, and use sex pheromone trap. They also use moss trap males with the codling moth lure trap, and release the egg parasitoid like Trichogramma embryopagum at 2000 per tree, and apply Virosoft CP4 granulovirus. That codling moth larvae must eat the virus before they enter the fruit. The spray DTVP or dichlorovos 0.04% and apply diazinon acetamiprid at 4 application per season during the egg laying stage. Here I end my presentation. Thank you.